coach when she hear of former gymnast Rachel Denali. One woman shared her horrific story that she had been hiding inside for years. Little did Rachel know that when she gained the courage to come forward publicly as a victim of child sexual assault, that she'd be helping hundreds of other women gain their courage to share their story. The journey that allowed Rachel to face a pedophile did not come without hardships. She was slandered through media and many other organizations. Rachel decided that she was no longer going to be a silent victim as she continued fighting for her justice. Rachel was a homeschooled. Around the age of 15, she started to have chronic back pain, so her coaches decided to send her to the orthopedic physician at Michigan State University, Larry Nassar. Larry Nassar is a 55-year-old man who is married to Stephanie Nassar. Together, they have three children, Caitlin, Ryan, and Caroline Nassar. Rachel went for her first visit with Larry Nassar, hoping to solve her chronic back pain, but she never came out the same. During the first appointment is when Larry Nassar started his monstrous tricks, sexually assaulting young Rachel within moments of first meeting her. Rachel went in for her first visit and never came out the same, feeling that something wasn't right, but was afraid to question such an idolized doctor. Rachel continued to be seen by Larry each year. Each visit, he assaulted Rachel again and again, at times with her mother just feet away. Imagine, being a young girl, the man, the doctor who's supposed to be helping you recover so you can continue to pursue your dreams, is a man who's destroying you in so many other ways. Rachel continued to keep her pain inside. Rachel now says, "I didn't want to draw any extra attention to it. I thought it was shameful enough." Rachel eventually did speak up for abuse. The first time was in 2004. Rachel was coaching at her local gym, and she heard another coach saying that she was going to send another gymnast that Rachel coached to see Dr. Nassar. Rachel said, "I thought I had to warn her, at least try to stop her," Rachel said, looking back on the moment. Later that year, Rachel also spoke to a nurse about the experience with Nassar and the so-called pelvic exams. The nurse suggested that Rachel file a complaint with the state medical board. Rachel wasn't ready. She said she was scared, and "I didn't want to file a report until I knew I could win." In August 2016, Rachel read an article published to the Indianapolis Star that claimed the USA Gymnastics failed to report allegations of abuse. Rachel immediately got in contact with the reporter at Indianapolis Star, and she told her that Rachel told her story and was later published 2 weeks later. Rachel was now the first to come forward about the public sexual abuse. Rachel went to Michigan State University ready to battle. "I knew it was going to be a fight," Rachel said. Rachel took all the evidence she had been gathering, holding for the past 16 years, including the journal she had been writing when her abuse began, that told the horrific stories of her abuse. Rachel filed a Title I complaint with the university, who had been covering up at least 8 other complaints against Nassar. Over 200 women spoke about the abuse that they received under the care of Larry Nassar. Rachel was the last to speak on the sentence hearing. On January 24, 2018, Rachel thanked Judge Rosemary Aquilina for giving her and all the victims a chance to reclaim their voices. Rachel's victim impact speech went to describe details of abuse she had received. Rachel asked, "How much is a little girl worth? How much is a young one worth?" Rachel answered her own questions. These victims are worth everything. During the hearings, other survivors spoke highly of Rachel, thanking her for giving them courage to tell their stories. Ultimately, Nassar was sentenced to 40 to 175 years in Michigan State Prison after pleading guilty to sexual assault of minors. Rachel's trial for Super had ended. Rachel's courage to speak up to lead to hundreds of other victims finding their voices. Judge Aquilina said, "Rachel, you have built an army of survivors. You are a five-star general. I believe that Rachel deserves to be in the Hall of Fame because she is looked up to by many girls in the world. She's a true hero. Rachel has proved that girls have a voice and we are powerful. Ask yourself, if Rachel has not spoke up, how many hundreds of victims would there be?" Due to Rachel's credit, she earned many awards. Some of the awards were the Inspiration of the Year Award, the Time 100 Honoree, the 2018 Woman of the Year Award, and the Arthur Ashe Courage Award. Now I'm going to play a 45-second video of Rachel's victim.
Larry is a hardened and determined sexual predator. I know this firsthand. His ability to gain my trust and the trust of my parents, his grooming and carefully calculated brazen sexual assault was the result of deliberate, premeditated, intentional, and methodological patterns of abuse patterns that were rehearsed long before I walked through Larry's exam room door, and which continue to be perpetrated, I believe, on a daily basis for 16 more years until I filed the police report. And while Larry is unlikely to live past his federal sentence, he is not the only predator out there. And this sentence will send a message about how seriously abuse will be taken. So I ask,